Hello and welcome back to another video. Today in this video I'll be showing you how you can use Hypic photo editing app on your mobile to edit your photos professionally. So if you want to use this app, first of all install this app in your mobile. I will place a link in description, then open it. You will get this interface. To import your photos, click on import. I will select this photo. Now I will show you all the tools we have in this app to edit photos. First option here is portrait. Now before discussing all these tools, make sure to subscribe this channel and press bell icon to get notifications of every new video. So first tool here is portrait. In portrait you can see first option is AI portrait, where you have some by default filters. You can use this AI portrait filters on your photo. In these AI filters you can see different categories. You can see all these AI portrait filters. Then second option is face. You can change edit your face, like you can resize your face, you can make your face small, increase the width, add dimple, decrease the size of cheekbones, jaw size, V shape or anything. So you can edit your face by using this face tool. With face tool you can see different options, like you can edit your eyes, you can edit your nose, eyebrows and also lips. So you can use these tools. Then there is resize option. Use this tool to increase size of anything in your photo, or you want to restore, you can use this tool. The next option is makeup. If you want to make up your photo by adding blush, eyelashes or anything, you can use these tools. Then in next option we have skin tone here. So if you want to change your skin tone, like now this is tan here, so the photo changed into black face, then I will select another skin tone, then the skin tone will be changed. So this is how you can change skin tone by using this skin tone tool. Then you can change the color of your hairs. After that, brush option, you can add any color in your photo. Like I want to add this brown color on photo, so I can use this tool here. Then we have erase option. You can erase on a specific site. Then makeup and highlighter is also available to edit your photos by using this brush tool. Now in eraser you can erase anything on your photo. For example, we have this window part here. I will select this color and now you can see this is removed. So by using this erase tool you can erase anything from your photo. We have cut out option in the last of portrait. By using this tool we can simply cut out background and make a PNG photo. Like I will select cut out here and I will click AI cut out. Now you can see this tool will, now you can see by using this AI cutout tool our photo is automatically selected and the background is removed. So if you want to change, erase your background and you want to make a PNG photo, you can use this tool. So all these tools are available in portrait. Then we have filter option. There are a lot of different filters with different categories. You can use these filters on your photo. In edges there are a lot of different tools to adjust your photo. Like you want to, if you want to crop your photo, you can use this crop tool. Then with that you can rotate your photo and add perspective on your photos like this. So you can use these tools. Then in selective part you can select a specific part in your photo and change the color of that part. Then you can use contrast, saturation, structure, light, warmth in your photo. So these are some adjust tools. And we have also AI enhance option here. Then we have HSL tool. By using this HSL tool you can change any color in your photo. Like color of shirt is yellow. If I select yellow color from the colors below, now we can change this yellow color to another color. Like now you can see this is turned into brown, and in this side this photo will be changed into black. So this is how you can use HSL to change any single color on your photo. Then you can increase the sharpness of photo and shadow warmth. All these adjustment tools are available to change to edit your photo. Now after adjust tools we have AI filters. In AI filters you can change your photo to AI art. Like If you select any of these AI arts, this photo will be automatically changed and will become an AI art. Like I will select one of these filters, one of these AI filters. Now you can see this photo has changed and it is become like cartoon photo. So you can use all these AI filters to change your photos. We have also some categories here. You can go through these all tools and you can use these AI filters on your photo. Then we have sticker option. In stickers, there are a lot of different stickers, and in first option you can import image as a sticker here. After stickers, we have text option. If you want to add some text, like I will add the name of this photo editor. Now in this text we can add different fonts. Like you can see there are a lot of different professional fonts. You can use these fonts on your photo, on your text. Then you can change the style of this text. Like you can change color of this text, also add stroke, shadow, background. If you want to add background to your photo, you can simply select color from your background color. Then we have format, change your photo. You can change your text into bold, italic. You can add underline and you can use any effect from all these texts. Then in next option, when you will add your text, there are other tools will appear. Like you can copy your text, you can add your text in order, and you can also edit your text further. Then in next option, there are effects. If you want to add some effects to your photo, like if you want to blur something, you want to add light, retro, or chromatic aberrations, there are a lot of different effects you can use on your photo. Then we have brush option. If you want to draw something on your photo, you can use this tool. You can choose the pattern for the drawing, and also we have different brushes here. You can use any one of these to draw something on your photo. Then in next, if we have a mosaic option, if you want to blur something on your photo and you want to add motion blur to your photos, you want to add crayon, or you want to paint something on your photo, you can use all these mosaic tools. After that we have background option. I have shown you earlier that how you can remove the background of your photo. If you want to add another background to your photo, you can use this tool. Also, when you will decrease the size of your photo, you can add some background to it by using this tool. In last option we have import. If you want to add another photo on your previous photo, you can simply add another photo to your photos. Like if you are making YouTube thumbnails, you can import your picture on already imported picture, and then on that photo we have different tools here. Like you can decrease the opacity, you can erase something on your photo, you can adjust this imported photo and add blend. You can also make some shapes by that photo. Also AI filters, I have already told you about this. Then you can crop, replace your picture, copy, flip, and you can delete that photo. So these are all the tools on Hypic photo editor to edit your photos professionally on your mobile. When your editing will be complete, to save your photo, click on arrow button on the top screen, then your photo will be saved into your gallery. So this is how you can use Hypic photo editing app on your mobile. I hope you will like this video. If you like this video, make sure to subscribe this channel. Thanks for watching.